So this is powertrain at its core, as raw as it gets. A lot of wiring in this new model. So it's, yeah, it's taken a long time, but we're getting there.
I keep referring back to the vehicle from my extensive history at McLaren Automotive, Tom Walkinshaw Racing, Brabham, and also volume automotive manufacturers. However, the requirements to fly are significantly more stringent than those I have applied in automotive. Many of the tools and processes are common, but this is another level. We're taking a systems-based approach to deliver a design with high levels of redundancy to ensure that no single fault can lead to loss of the primary function, that is controlled flight. We're making increased use of simulation, hardware in the loop, and also formal integration testing to ensure that we're delivering ever-increasing levels of safety. Proving these systems on the Mark III brings us closer to having a pilot on board with the future Airspeeder. If any of the systems were to fail on the vehicle, the redundant architecture and the fault handling ensure that the vehicle remains controllable in the air, albeit with reduced performance.
The levels of safety that we now have in the powertrain is just going up by magnitudes, so we're monitoring things so much more closely now.
All systems are monitored by telemetry. This means that the crew operating the vehicle are immediately alerted to any issue and can take the appropriate response to land the vehicle in a safe location. The controls required to deliver this level of functionality are very complex and require a rigorous level of testing to verify their function at a subsystem level.